What's up, guys? Welcome back to the show. Welcome back to another video. And in today's video, a lot of you guys have been asking me what's going on with the M5, where's your wife's car, a bunch of stuff. And I'm just like, hey, we got the F80. I'm trying to enjoy it for a minute. But you know what? I do gotta keep you guys posted with that stuff. So first things first, there is huge news on the M5. Yeah, officially, it's actually amazing news for me, at least. We did another mod to my wife's car. It's actually a Carly giveaway, another Carly giveaway in the end of this video, so make sure to stay tuned. And the shout outs to everyone that's caught merch since the last video. So first things first, actually, I'm just gonna go in and pop it up right here. Shout out to everyone right over here that's caught merch to support the channel. All these people's names are pretty much gonna be featured on the F80 plaque. If you guys haven't copped anything yet, make sure to do so to be featured on the F80 build, because once this page fills up, that's the end of that. I can't make a bigger page. I just want one page to put on a plaque. So if you guys are gonna be part of the F80 build, get your name on that list, because it is pretty much full. So yeah, guys, shout out to everyone right on this list. Again, you guys are helping me out so much, and I really do appreciate it. But now let's go ahead and get into my wife's car real quick before the M5 news, because my wife got a new mod on her car. Cue the cinematic. Yeah, she had an oil catch can. We definitely needed to install that onto the car. I mean, we need to do the preventative maintenance to make sure nothing goes wrong with her daily. We got a backup camera. We did Apple CarPlay. We upgraded her charge pipe. We upgraded her intercooler. We were pretty much doing major maintenance at the same time modifying it, so it's pretty awesome. And the oil catch can just brings this really nice touch to the engine bay. So yeah, had to show you guys that little neat mod. If you guys want that burger tuning oil catch can, it's like a new style. It's very, very, very aesthetically pleasing. If you guys want that oil catch can, it's gonna be linked down below. But yeah, the news that everyone's been waiting for before I actually mention the Carly giveaway is the M5. So yeah, I figured out that apparently Copart takes trade-ins. Like, I don't know if you guys know that, but even if you don't have a license or anything with Copart, you literally just call up Copart and be like, hey, I got a car to trade in. And they give you a really, like, fair price, to be honest. They even see on the website that we don't lowball. We offer something reasonable with the expectation that they're going to be flipping it. And obviously, they're offering you a price with a car that they know nothing about. They're not going to come diagnose it. So, I mean, they literally offered me a price over the phone and came with the check and picked it up same day. So I was so happy. But yeah, let's go ahead and get into that footage, because that is some exciting stuff.
All right, guys, good morning. Welcome back to the channel. And in today's video, we are trading in the M5 to Copart. So apparently Copart has a trade-in system that I knew nothing about, and you don't actually have to be a Copart member to be able to trade in your car. I am a Copart member, but just for those of you guys who don't know Copart, they offer a lot more than pick and pull, obviously, because actually they send their cars off to the auction. This is a clean title. I will tell you guys how much they offered us in the end of the video, but a pretty happy price. And they don't even want any of the carbon fiber that's on the car. They actually prefer that it's off of the car, even the carbon fiber trunk, and I have the original trunks. Let's go ahead and take off all of our carbon fiber pieces and then put this thing back to stock and then send it off to Copart. I'm super stoked. Without further ado, this is the before angle with all the regular carbon fiber. And just like that, guys, you have the carbon fiber all removed. You have the trunk, the original, not the original trunk. This one is actually from a pre-LCI. It does have the keyhole right there, which does not work with this car, but all the mechanisms and everything works. You can close the trunk and lock the trunk. See, I mean, it's all one color at this point. All the carbon, like I said, is removed. Let's go ahead and call up Copart and see if they can come pick her up.
Good morning, guys. This is the next day. Actually, just a couple days later. It is Wednesday. You guys saw me taking apart the M5 on a Sunday, so I got all the mods off of the car. Basically, they told me they're gonna offer me less if I left all the carbon on the car. And I was like, you know what? I got the original trunk, man. I'll take off all the carbon. I'll sell that separately. Royal Gravy and the Navy. And they decided to honor their price. Again, I'll tell you guys the price at the end of the video because I cannot believe they offered me this much for a car that doesn't even drive. It is a clean title. Doesn't drive though. Doesn't even start. And they offered me a very, very fair price. Like, they are not low ballers. They're not like a pick and pull or anything like that. They offer you something very reasonable. So yeah, anyhow, let's head back to my place and get the car loaded up because the tow truck driver is almost here. So here we are back home, guys. There is the M5. Let's see if it's gonna be quick and easy. The tow truck driver said he's about 5 minutes away, so let's see if it's gonna be hard to pretty much sign over the car. The pink slip is not under my name. I do have the title from another person to my name, and I have a bill of sale from me to them. So let's see if all that stuff works out as well. So it's a little bit of a complicated transaction, but if I can do it, guys, you guys can do it, and they offer pretty decent prices. Like I said, stay tuned to the end of the video to see what the offer is, but honestly, guys, I am not joking around. I'm not trying to clickbait you guys. The offer is very, very, very reasonable compared to all the offers I got on Offroad, Facebook, all that. And on top of that, we got to keep the carbon fiber, which you got to make some more money off of. So it is just a win-win. Wish me luck. I'm kind of stressed out. I'm really hoping this deal goes through, but it is Copart. They are pretty legit. So yeah, pretty stoked. They are just loading up the car right now, guys. Oh my God, it is actually going. Well, it is what it is, guys. That is just crazy. So I don't know if you guys know, but if you go to Copart.com and you type in Copart trade-in, not Copart like sending the cars off to the auction, but Copart trade-in on Google, they have a link that takes you to a website that you can trade in your cars to them. They give you an instant cash offer online. So I went ahead and took that cash offer online. I gave them a call and I was like, hey, I'd like to accept this offer. They went ahead and told me to send some pictures. I sent some pictures. It was an entire process. But end of the day, once I sent the pictures, they sent me an offer of $4,800. And I was like, why? Why would you guys give me $4,800? And you guys saw, that's the reason why we took off all the carbon, because they actually thought the carbon decreased the value of the car. So I actually took all the carbon off of the car, put back the original parts, bada bang, back up to $5,900, which I was super happy about. Because I didn't even know what to do with the original parts. I was gonna literally throw them away. But the carbon parts, they have some good value in them. So anyway, I was so, so, so happy. They came by, picked it up, like no questions asked, signed a few bill of sale documents, and bada bing, bada bang, they gave me a check for $5,900. And honestly, guys, that is just a blessing in itself. I honestly couldn't believe it. The reason why it took me so long to sell the car wasn't because no one was trying to buy it. It was mainly because I was holding it for the previous owner. The previous owner hit me up like literally a day or two after I put it up for sale, and he was like, hey, I'd like to purchase the vehicle tomorrow. So I was like, all right, I'll wait on you tomorrow. No response for that day. Waited the next day, no response. An entire week, every single day I hit him up, I was like, hey bro, like I'm trying to move on with my videos. I'm trying to sell this car. Can you like, I didn't tell him the entire story, but I was like, when are you gonna come pick up the car that you said you want? It's your car, which I'm holding for you. Well, obviously not his car, but used to be his car. And I figured if anyone knows what's wrong with it, it's gonna be this guy. So I held the car for him. And throughout that week, a bunch of people that know the previous owner has been hitting me up, and everyone that literally mentions his name doesn't end up showing up. And I'm just getting so annoyed. I'm like, are they playing games with me? I don't know what's going on. But anywho, another week goes by, and then he hits me up again. He was like, hey, I'd like to pick up the car tomorrow. And I was like, are you for sure? He's like, for sure. And I was like, all right, come get it. Week goes by, doesn't pick it up. I was like, you know what? I'm done with this guy. I'm done with all the people that know him. I'm just gonna go ahead, trade it into Copart. And I don't know, cause I don't know who to trust anymore. It's kind of becoming really weird and I got tired of it. And I was like, you know what? This car seems to be cursed. So I'm just gonna go ahead and send it to Copart, get rid of it, and just not deal with it. And I'm just so happy, so relieved. Time for the new M build on the channel, guys. And now for those of you guys who stick throughout to the end of the video, yep, I got another Carly adapter. We got one right here, brand new Carly adapter. I went ahead and just got another one just because, hey, guys, we gotta put on the i8 exhaust. And I wanna give Vibetronic one more shout out right before we install, because I just wanna give them a little bit more love before we actually slap this thing on. This is gonna be an absolutely insane exhaust. I've literally seen nobody else on YouTube that owns an i8 that put a full exhaust system, not to mention a Vibetronic exhaust. So this is pretty exciting, because when you put it like on the hybrid mode or eco mode or whatever, you're not gonna have any exhaust. It's gonna be really nice, very quiet. And then when you actually put it on sport, it's gonna sound absolutely insane. And on top of that, you guys are gonna get a Carly adapter. If you guys wanna enter the giveaway, it's as easy as subscribing to my channel, subscribing to Valvetronic, link down below, and then just commenting on Valvetronic. I mean, I'm gonna have a video linked. You just click on that video and just comment on the video saying, like, I don't know, great video or whatever you guys wanna say. Just comment something and I'll choose a winner from the comments of Valvetronic's latest video. And just make sure you subscribe to Valvetronic. Subscribe to Valvetronic, subscribe to myself, and comment on the latest video. Without further ado, guys, if you guys want to be shot on the next video, make sure to cop some merch. Remember, as soon as that list gets full, that's the end of that. We got so many mods coming in for the F80, and I am so stoked. Without further ado, guys, I love y'all so much. Remember to stay humble. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.